The national conversation, a process in which residents participated in discussion at public meetings on major issues affecting these islands, were high on the agenda. Lead organizer of the national conversation, Charlene Cartwright Robinson, said the dialogue has gone extremely well thus far.
Okay, the first phase, actually the both were supposed to have run together, but after we got the issue of the issuance of the joint ministerial statement with regards to the milestones to accomplish, we purposefully took a break to reassess and to see if we can organize more pointed discussions and have more discussions with persons. Phase one was really, as far as I'm concerned, very successful in terms of the recommendations, because what we're looking for is recommendations that came from the former leaders, from persons like John, in the tourism sector, and then the discussion on the economy, which is very, very useful, even now to the interim administration in the absence of our full report. But the second phase is really to get out there and hear from persons generally on issues affecting this country, and to hear from them generally in public meetings. So we're going into town hall meetings where we're going to hit every island, and we're going to be discussing issues not necessarily limited to the milestones to be accomplished or the recommendations or discussions we've had in the first phase, but generally the issues they see affecting this country.
Cartwright Robinson added that the second phase will see electoral reform, the civil service, belongership and immigration as hot-button issues. On Tuesday, January 18th, public meeting on Grand Turk at 6 p.m. at the St. Stephen James Hall. Thursday, January 20th, meeting with the political parties and poll workers on electoral reform at the Gustavus Leibman Sports Complex at 5:30 p.m. Also Thursday, public meeting at 7:30 p.m. at the Gustavus Leibman Sports Complex. On Friday, January 21st, expressions on Radio Turks and Caicos at 10 a.m. with Dr. Linda Williams on civil service and education. Then a meeting at 2 p.m. with pastors in Providenciales. Tuesday, January 25th, public meeting at the Community Center in Kunkbar, Middle Caicos, starting at 3 p.m., then at the Whitby Community Center on North Caicos at 7 p.m. Saturday, January 29th, at the Community Center, Salt Key at 6 p.m., then Tuesday, February 1st, the Iris Dobbs Primary School in South Caicos at 6 p.m. Cartwright Robinson said overall their main goal is to be heard and to prove that Turks and Caicos Islanders are capable and well-equipped to solve their own problems.
What we're trying to achieve is actually, I personally believe that a lot of the solutions to our problems rest and lies right in the Turks and Caicos. If you would have listened to the forum on Tuesday past, you would have heard the Honorable Derek Taylor, former chief minister, saying that the advisors that are coming in don't understand the dynamics of this country. And you cannot seek to implement changes or policies at the exclusion of Turks and Caicos Islanders. We are the ones who would have known what worked, what didn't work. We are the ones who have to carry it out eventually where the British are gone. So it's important for the involvement of Turks and Caicos Islanders. And so far, a lot has been done through our exclusion. And what we're trying to do is get our voice in there to say that we're prepared, we have recommendations, we have solutions, and we must be heard. That is the main goal of the national conversation.